failure.
Good afternoon. Today's headlines are: another 4,000 civilians died in the war in Gaza. The polar ices are now completely melted, and massive floods are to be expected. But today's biggest news is the new fantastic Kevlar firefighter suit that just recently was introduced to the staff of Västerås Rescue Fire Division. Reporter Greta Inga is sending live from the station. Greta, what is the situation like in Västerås?
I'm standing here together with the designer of the firefighter suit, Miss Anderson. Why is this suit such a revolutionary invention?
Oh, the Kevlar fiber is fire resistant, extremely strong, and has a low density. But most importantly, my design is extraordinary.
But how did you come up with the idea to use Kevlar in this suit?
Oh, I have always had an interest in plastic. So when I became a part of the project to develop a new firefighter suit, it was obvious to me to use Kevlar, since it is non-flammable until 200 to 260 degrees. And another positive thing is that it never gets old.
Oh, thank you, Miss Anderson.
Thank you.
But now I think we need to know a little bit about the chemical structure of Kevlar. With us inside from the station, we have Dr. Oetker.
Yes, Kevlar is indeed a super material which is even fire resistant. But how is this possible? I think we better take a closer look on the molecule structure to find that out.
Kevlar is a so-called aramid polymer and consists of two substances. They are called paraphenylenediamine and terephthalic acid. And when you mix these two substances, you get a topic chain that looks like this. These are called aromatic hydrocarbons, and you don't need to know anything more than that they are very flat, and that makes it possible to pack these chains very tightly together. So you can say Kevlar is a very dense substance. And as you can see, we have oxygen here and hydrogen here. And since hydrogen is a very electronegative substance, a dipole has now occurred, and we have the chain is minus loaded on this side and plus loaded on this side and this one also. And therefore you can now attach these chains to each other, and the bindings between the chains are called hydrogen bindings, and they are the strongest bindings you can find in nature, the strongest bindings that nature has to offer us. So that is one reason to why Kevlar is so strong. The other reason is that this chain is also very long, so there are not only strong bindings, but also a lot of them.
So, now I hope you know a bit more about Kevlar and its chemical structure. And I really think that the firemen should feel proud and safe with this new suit.
Nothing can possibly go wrong with this suit. Nothing can possibly go wrong with this suit.
Fire!
Fire!
Kevlar saved me.